హార్వర్డ్ విశ్వవిద్యాలయంలో నటి తనుశ్రీ దత్త సందర్శించింది. లైంగిక వేధింపులను తాను ఎలా ఎదుర్కొంది స్టూడెంట్స్ తో షేర్ చేసుకుంది. ఆమె స్ఫూర్తితో భారత్లో మీటూ ఉద్యమం బలపడ్డం చూశాం. మరింత మంది మహిళలు ధైర్యంగా బయటకు వచ్చి తమకు జరిగిన అనుభవాల్ని బయటపెట్టారు. ఇండియా కాన్ఫరెన్స్ లో తనుశ్రీతో పాటు పాల్గొన్న భారత విద్యార్థి, ఐటీ నిపుణుడు, ఇంకా వాల్ స్ట్రీట్ అధికారి టీవీ 9 ఏమన్నారో చూద్దాం.
The Harvard conference, India conference, is a very prestigious conference. So a lot of people from all walks of life, andaru vastaru ikkada. So a lot of topics untayi, today event avutundi ikkada. So danlo mem participate cheyadaniki
vachukunnam. And meeku interest in a topic entandi ante ee 2 days lo మీ ఇంట్రెస్టింగ్ టాపిక్
టెక్నాలజీ ఇన్నోవేషన్ అండ్ ఆల్సో సమ్ ఆఫ్ ది టాపిక్స్ ఏంటంటే మనకి హౌ టు గివ్ బ్యాక్ బేసిక్గా సొసైటీకి ఎలాగైనా ఇవ్వచ్చు ఇలాంటి టాపిక్స్ వెరీ వెరీ ఇన్స్పైరింగ్.
మీరు కూడా మాట్లాడుతున్నారా?
ఈసారి చాలా లాస్ట్ మినిట్లో వచ్చింది. ఐఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు బి ఇన్ ద నెక్స్ట్ ప్యానల్స్ నెక్స్ట్ ఇయర్.
హార్వర్డ్ బిజినెస్ ఇండియా కాన్ఫరెన్స్ ఈవెంట్కి వీఆర్ కమింగ్ హియర్. మై ఇంట్రెస్ట్ ఈస్ ఇన్ ద ఫైనాన్షియల్ సర్వీసెస్ యాజ్ అ వాల్ స్ట్రీట్ ఎగ్జిక్యూటివ్. What's happening in India, akkada ela integrate cheddamu ikkada Wall Street's financial services and the fintech and technology enabled services, we will try to help and enable the opportunities.
I'm doing my MPA, Masters in Public Administration, in the Harvard Kennedy School, second year student, so one of the co-chairs of the India conference. So India conference anedi it's the 16th edition, so this is something that we've been doing for about 15 years now. It's an annual event anamata, so largely focus entante it's about key issues in India, so to bring it on the global stage on a platform like Harvard, something that we are surprised ikkada inta India population unna gaani India gurinchi conversations chala takku. So in fact this is the largest such gathering for it to discuss issues based on India. In the better than day, we have about 120 speakers coming in from India over 2 days. So it's jointly organized by Harvard Kennedy School and Harvard Business School. So Okuroj Kennedy School, Okuroj Business School, we talk about issues ranging from business, politics, governance, policy issues, grassroots politics, etc. So this year's conference is interesting.
What is the main goal for this conference?
అంటే అది చెప్పినట్టు నేను ఇక్కడ హార్వర్డ్ కెనడీలో చదువుతాను. వీ హ్యావ్ సో మెనీ సబ్జెక్ట్స్ కోర్సెస్ ఆన్ చైనా, ద గ్రోత్ ఆఫ్ చైనా, ఇండియా బీయింగ్ ప్రాబ్లీ ఈక్వల్ ఇన్ టర్మ్స్ ఆఫ్ ద పాపులేషన్ బట్ నాట్ మచ్ ఇస్ డిస్కస్డ్ ఆన్ ఇండియా. సో ఇలాంటి కాన్వర్సేషన్స్ వల్ల ఏమవుతుందంటే దెర్ ఇస్ అ సెన్స్ ఇన్ ద యూనివర్సిటీ దట్ దెర్ ఇస్ సో మచ్ హ్యాపెనింగ్ ఇన్ ఇండియా అండ్ సమ్ ఆఫ్ ద ప్రొఫెసర్స్ హియర్ ఆర్ ఒబ్లివియస్ టు ఇట్. సో దీస్ కాన్వర్సేషన్స్ వల్ల courses develop aitai on India, which is very important. I mean, Indians contribute so much to the US economy, and is that being discussed is something that we are not really sure of. So anduke this is one of our ways to engage with the audience here. In fact, attendees, it's attended by about 1,000 audiences, and from New York, Boston, San Francisco, they fly in because they want to listen to what's happening in India. Premo inka elections rabothundi, 2019 is the election, 2019 though. So we are talking about what, so in fact NRIs can vote right now.
Yes.
So we are educating the voter on what's happening in India and maybe make an informed choice on what they can do with the voting.
Prastham mantho padu Miss India Tanushree Datta and alage Me Too movement India lo India ki teesukochina Tanushree Datta gar mantho padu unnaru. So what makes you bring you to this India conference in Harvard University?
Get a panel, a discussion about the media role in shaping society, and also they had a discussion about the hashtag MeToo movement in India and the impact, and should the media be censored. So it was a combination of different ideas that were thrown around at the panel.
10 years ago you lodged a complaint but you did not see any result, but again very recently you brought up this issue. Do you think that you got any solution for it?
Well, I think the only solution that came out of it was there was awareness. A lot of people had chosen to not acknowledge that somebody was harassed and troubled on at work and had to walk away from their career and job because of it, and which is a very common problem that happens all over the world, especially in India. that, you know, the women, you know, and also sometimes young men at, you know, that there's a power dynamic, you know. So workplace harassment can really impact a person's life. So me speaking up this time, the only tangible result that I can see is that it motivated a lot of other people to speak up and, you know, be free from these secrets that they had been holding because of fear of speaking up. And some people got justice also, some form of justice. Sometimes justice can also be a social justice when you name and shame these abusers and harassers. At least you have the satisfaction that, you know, you were able to warn somebody else. So yeah, I see that kind of response and it makes me feel happy.
And don't you think, like, you know, you should have stayed back in India for some more days and then, like, some concrete result, like, you should have got some concrete result and then come back to US?
Well, I had to come back to the US because I live here. It's my home. And, you know, if by concrete result, if you mean a legal process, that's a really gray zone in India. So you can, you know, take the legal recourse. Like this time around, of course, there's a proper FIR in place, but the investigation is so slow. And, you know, if you know the legal system in India and how it can be manipulated by perpetrators, you know, especially when you're lodging a complaint after 10 years, with 10 years gap, you know. So it's any which way is a complicated case to pursue. And especially being in India and the legal system, so you can't stop your life, you know, to get justice, because there is no poetic justice in a person who's been victimized once, gets victimized again when they're speaking up because all kinds of accusations are thrown at you, and then to live your life and, you know, sit there pursuing something that happened 10 years ago, where is the poetic justice in that, you know? Sometimes you don't speak up because you're expecting a certain kind of result. Sometimes you speak up because it has to be, the awareness has to be created. So.
And don't you think, like, you were really bold? Don't you think people like you should enter politics and then bring a change?
I have no interest in politics.
But, like, you know, don't you think that, you know, that will, like, through that, like, you know, you can bring some changes in the country?
I really don't want to enter politics because I don't have, I am a very strong person, I agree that, but I know my own nature. I don't have the nature for politics. I would rather influence people that listen to me or that understand what I'm saying, and by influencing them I can bring about a change in society. I don't want to actively get involved in any field because I know myself very well. I know what kind of lifestyle I like to lead. You know, when you see me at panel discussions, of course I'm interacting with people and there's a lot of sometimes heated debate and sometimes, but in my everyday life I like to live in solitude. I prefer to stay by myself. I don't have too many friends, and I read a lot, I listen to stuff a lot, I write and I pray and I meditate. So that's my personality. I can come out from time to time to create an impact in the world, but I will lose myself, you know what I'm saying, if I'm in an environment which is very hostile or aggressive.
Is it just that controversy which made you come to America?
No, I've always liked America, actually. I first came to America in 2004 after my Miss India pageant, and I really loved it. But I went back because I was getting movie offers. And then in 2010, I came to America again to, you know, take a break, to live here. I lived here for 3 months. I loved it. And then so it was a gradual process. In 2016, when I knew that I would not be returning to Bollywood, is when I decided to move to America and, you know, apply for my green card and immigration and all that.
So, I mean, like, in the recent times also, like, you were a crucial person, like, you know, in bringing the Me Too movement to India. But even now, a lot of other actresses also, like, I mean, a few of them did not support you, and then there was a lot of things, like, troll going on you. How were you feeling during that time?
Feels bad. It feels bad, but what can you do? You just have to do what you're called to do. You know, and like I said, it happened. I ended up raising the issue again. It was not my intention when I went back to India. My intention was to just spend time with family. but in the way of conversation it came up, you know, in the media. So, you know, I'm used to it. I'm used to this kind of aggressive and, you know,